Greetings. Welcome to my YouTube tutorial, how to create a 360 video with telemetrics data inside the video. This is not easy, but it can be done. The GoPro software allows you to make cool videos, but the software that GoPro is providing only makes pancake videos. And I don't want that. I want to keep the 360 video aspect intact. I want to take a look around in my videos and I want to project the telemetric data inside the video. I will show you later how this will look. First, some preparation. Of course, you have recorded a video. Make sure that you have a decent video, preferably a longer video. Short bursts of videos are actually a lot of work. It is better to make one long shot and then cut out the unimportant parts later. That is less work, because synchronizing is the most time-consuming part. Of course, you have a bike computer. That is a necessity because the bike computer has all the important metrics. All the high-end bike computers, like the Hammerhead, the Garmin, the Mio Cyclo, the Karoo Hammerhead, they all record every second some metrics about your biking. In my case, my bike computer records the temperature, the altitude, the speed, the power I am pushing on the pedals, and also important, the cadence, so my frequency, and also my heart rate frequency. Okay, the thing you have to have installed is the GoPro player. That is free software, no restrictions, and Verb Edit. And Verb Edit is made by Garmin. The links for the software are in the description. And also my steps are in the description, so you can take a look back at the steps anytime. Okay, how are we going to do this? First of all, copy the 360 files from the GoPro to the computer. Although the GoPro connects like a memory popping up in your computer, the GoPro conversion software cannot convert directly from the GoPro. I think only one video at a time, and I make multiple videos, so copy all the files to your computer. Then use the GoPro player to convert it to MP4. I will show you, it looks like this. This is the GoPro converter, and you can check out the codec. There are only three types: 264, HEVC, and Cineform. Cineform is default, but that doesn't work. You need HEVC. Got it? So, connect your bike computer or have the GPS file ready, because you need the file in Verb Edit. Import the video in Verb Edit. Then put the video on an empty timeline. Insert the metrics from the bike computer, and then comes the detective work. Find out where your video was recorded. Step number 8, we're going to use this. But it doesn't really work that well, because actually the GPS of the GoPro is actually not that great. I can show you why. It makes mistakes. And we're talking about 500 meter mistakes. 300 yards mistakes, or even more. Check out for landmarks and open the sync options. Check if the sync is correct. This is important, because you have to make sure that the synchronization is correct. I like the statistics, but I want the statistics to be correct, of course. And for each video fragment, you have to repeat step 7 until 12. So if you have 4 shots, you have to synchronize 4 times. Right? Okay. So let's go back to the source files. These are the source files. Let's go back here. This is the bike ride I did. Yeah. And the fit file, which is actually used, is this one. And it was a bike ride on April 27, 2021. The original GoPro file is 2.1 gigabytes, and I already converted it, and the conversion is almost twice that size. It is 3.75 gigabytes. Okay, let's go to Verb Edit. In Verb Edit, we're going to create a video, and we're going to call it tutorial video. And I'm going to import the video in the timeline. Right. You can see that this is a 360 video. And I am on the cycle path. And the sun is around here. And this is late in the afternoon. So I am cycling to the west. Okay, now comes the detective work. Now we have to find out where was this video recorded. Well, you can't see it very well, but here there is water. And these are houses from a small town. So, let's go back to the software that GoPro is actually not providing, but this is made by an amateur. It has a premium option, but we want the free option. And we're going to say, well, check out where the video is made. And we're going to open it. And it doesn't upload the entire video. It only reads the GPS data inside the video container. It takes usually 30 seconds. So it doesn't upload the video, it only uploads the part in the container where the GPS data is stored. Okay. Well, check out the stream and view map. So this is the recording from the GPS. It is looping all the time. So check out the map. Well, I was correct. There is water on the left side and I'm cycling to the northwest. But this doesn't seem right. And especially the red part. And you can see that it is flashing. This is totally incorrect. So we have a clue where the start of the video is, but this part is incorrect because I did not cross the water there. In fact, there is no bridge. So this is clearly a mistake from the GoPro. Thank you, GoPro. Okay, let's go back to the Verb Edit. Now we have to tell the computer where the video was synced. So. And you can see here a lightning bolt and a cloud, and that is the symbol for the metrics. And the metrics, we're going to import a separate file, and it was April 27. So April 27, this one. Yeah, this seems about right. And then I say use this log. So now I am not done. because the video and the data are not synchronized. Why are they not synchronized? Well, the video did not start at the beginning of the ride. And that is the basic setting for the Verb Edit software. So we're going to click, this is the most important button, the lightning bolt and the cloud. We're going to synchronize the data. So where is this video shot? Well, we know that it is around, probably around here. But we're not sure. And we have to be sure because my bike computer is storing the data every second. So, where was it in the video? Do you remember it? Take a look at the satellite. Check out the factory here. Zoom a little bit out. There's a factory here. And here's a corner. Now let's go back to the software. And the software, the satellite shot. So the software is actually thinking that the video is starting here. So around this part. Well, let's assume that the software is correct. It isn't, but let's assume the software is correct. So it should be here. Well, we're going to drag the red dot, and the red dot is the GPS locator, and we're going to drag it around here. Let's go back to the software. Yeah, here is water. So it's actually at the water where the video is actually starting. So here. Let's go back to the video, to the GPS. Yeah, a few meters after the water. Probably here. And then we're going to say to the computer, done. Okay, now I'm going to use a template. And the template will show me the metrics I'm interested in, and you can adjust the templates to your wishes. Well, and for this video, the cadence is important, and I'm going to use the cadence to check if the video is synchronized, because if we move around in the video, you can see that I am, where are they? Ah, here. There are speed bumps. Really Dutch thing to do. Speed bumps to slow down bike traffic. And what I do in cycling, I keep my legs quiet. So it should be, and I hope you can hear it, it's not in sync. You could hear that in the second moment I crossed the speed bump, you can clearly hear that I was resting my legs, but the cadence did not drop. So this means is that it is not synchronized. So let's go back to the detective work part 2. And that is landmarks. We're going to synchronize now on landmarks. So we are going to ignore the GPS video from GoPro, but we are going to spin the video forward and we're going to look for landmarks, very clear landmarks. And oh, this is a perfect landmark, a bridge. So I'm spinning the video here, and we are exactly at the bridge. Now I'm going to go back to the menu here, and you can see that we're not at the bridge, so that the synchronization I did was off. So I'm going to slide it back to the bridge and make a new synchronization. And then I'm going to say done. Okay, now let's do the speed bump test again, because the speed bumps are around here. And the cadence should drop because I'm resting my legs. Yes, they're dropping. Second time. Yes, they're dropping. Perfect. Now, we could do another check. At the end of the video, there's a corner, and I have to slow down to make the corner in time. Where is the corner? Here's the corner. And I'm resting my legs. You can see that I am now zero cadence. So I'm resting my legs for quite some time. So let's see if we can hear it. Yeah. And you can hear a small click. And the click was the moment I start pedaling again. And the click seems to be perfectly aligned with the cadence. So, and everybody is telling me that I have a strong tailwind. No, the wind is coming from the side. But this is how you should synchronize the video. And the last step is to export the video. Of course, this takes 15 minutes, and then upload the video to YouTube. That takes another minutes, and then YouTube has to prepare the video for 360, and that could take up almost to 12 hours before YouTube can see the entire video. And if you want to take a look at the result video is over here. No, I haven't rendered it yet, no. But this is the way to synchronize the videos. So, recap from the beginning. You have a bike video, you have a bike computer, and a bike computer has to be a modern one with GPS and with the possibility with the option to record your activity every second. A GoPro player to convert the video, because Garmin Edit cannot read the 360 videos. In fact, a lot of software cannot read the 360 videos. Then the process itself. Copy the files to the computer, convert them, connect your bike computer so that you can have the metrics file, import the video, put the video on an empty timeline, insert the metrics from the bike computer, and now the detective work, find out where your video was shot. So use the GPS extractor, or use landmarks, and then open the sync options. And the sync options are the important part. Check if the sync is correct. If you don't have anything to check it with, you can use corners to check if the sync is correct. You can check out specific landmarks, stuff like that. If you have multiple videos, you have to repeat this. Yeah? It's the end. Thanks for watching.